bless you. Welcome to Retro, Getting It All Back. We love coming into your homes every week with the word of the Lord, where you will be set free. Today is a very special program. It's the fourth part of my series on deadly toxic emotions. Today we're dealing with fear. Fear, false evidence appearing real. Has fear got a hold of you for anything at all? Intimidated, anxious? Today you're going to be set free, for the power of the Word of God is going to be preached in this house. So many folks were set free today. Someone even heard the chains and the shackles of fear dropping to the ground, and you could be set free also. The power of God. The power of God. Fear versus faith. Faith versus fear. You make your mind up today. You choose what you're going to choose today. Fear or faith? Oh, choose faith. Faith comes by hearing the word of the Lord. Fear comes by hearing the lies of the devil, your adversary. Oh, it's such a good program. Pull up, call a friend, anyone that's experiencing any kind of intimidation or fear, they will be set free today. I promise you, through the power of God that's going to come through your screen. First, we're going to have Shabbat. Oh, what a ministry today. Climb every mountain. Yeah, we go through it all, but we come victoriously to the other side. God bless you. Let's go into Shabbat now.
That's why I pray.
Word of God. And today, I culminate this series of deadly emotions with fear. Anybody need a pen? Elder John's got a pen for you. We get you all set up here. Amen, amen, amen. We culminate it with fear, okay? I'm going to begin in Isaiah 41:10, which is my most favorite scripture that I have in every one of my Bibles marked on. There's tears on it. There's all kinds of marks on it. Because how many times has God told me this? A gazillion. How much is a gazillion?
A bunch.
A bunch. Go ahead.
Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand.
Amen. Fear not. How many know this scripture? How many have it underlined in your Bible? How many have received it as a word of the Lord? This is a positive word of the Lord because fear sometimes overwhelms us. Could be the slightest thing, but it's a deadly, toxic emotion. It could paralyze you. Amen? It could absolutely, you could almost tremble with it. You can get sick over it. And fear is mentioned over 600 times in the Word. Amen? God commanded his people not to fear. It's a commandment. He's not just saying, you know, don't. He's saying, fear not. I am your God. I am with you. I think sometimes God gets indignant with us to say, excuse me, have I not brought you through every valley? Have I not caused you to succeed? Well, what do you think? I'm going to leave you now. Fear not. It was a commandment throughout the Word. We read it. We read it as he gives that command to Israel, as he gives it to Moses, as he spoke through David, as he gave it to Daniel, as he gave it to all of his disciples on the Sea of Galilee, as he told Peter, Peter, you foolish person, why did you doubt? Why did you fear? Why did you sink? You will either control your fear or it will control you. You will either conquer your fear or your fear will conquer you. It's choice. It's fear or it's faith. It's fear or it's faith. The choice is yours. Today, I pray that you will choose faith. What is fear? Fear is a frightening, strong emotion caused by
anticipation of the worst, to be afraid, feel uncertain, anxious, a mental state caused by the Prince of Darkness.
Caused by who? By who?
The Prince of Darkness.
Ah, because God has not given you a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. So if God didn't give you that spirit of fear, who gave it to you?
Prince of Darkness.
Do you understand that? Fear does not come from God. Fear comes from your enemy. That's why you cannot allow yourself to live in fear. Do you hear me? There is the emotion of fear, and that's God-given. And there's a spirit of fear that's from Satan himself. Do you understand that? There's two kinds of fear. Now, they're totally different. Now, let's talk about the spirit of fear, okay? The spirit of fear comes from the Prince of Darkness. It is described by psychologists and psychiatrists as phobias, okay? There are 642 phobias producing abnormal, irrational minds with crippling fear. Can you ever imagine that? That could really, without Christ, you're doomed. Every little thing becomes, you become phobic to it because the door is open in your head and anything can walk in. You understand that? Let me tell you some of these phobias. Ablutophobia is the fear of washing and bathing. Hello? Acleophobia is the fear of darkness. Acousticophobia is the fear of noise. Agoraphobia is the fear of heights. Acuneophobia is the fear of open, high places. Do you ever, I remember we went up to the Empire State Building one time when we were visiting it one time in New York. You know, I lived in New York for many, many years, and you know I never went to the Empire State Building. I had to move out of the state. And when I went back in, brought my granddaughters up there, and we went up to the top floor. And you know, you're just almost like you feel, wow, we're too high, it's too quiet. It's so, now New York City is the noisiest city. Da, 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 everything is noisy. But when you get up there and you look out, it's a hush that you can't even take in. So that's what this means, open high places. Now, I'm not phobic about it. I'd do it again. Agiliophobia means the fear of pain. Azuchiophobia is the fear of wild animals. Aleuophobia is fear of cats. Allergophobia is the fear of pain. Altophobia is the fear of heights. Amaxophobia is fearing of riding in a car. Ambulophobia is a fear of walking. Are you naming yourself? None of these on me, honey. Okay. Ankrophobia is the fear of the wind. Angrophobia is the fear of becoming angry. Anupiaphobia is the fear of staying single. Just saying. Apheniophobia is the fear of being touched. How many know some people don't like to be touched? That's a phobia. Okay, astrophobia is the fear of thunder and lightning. Ataxophobia is the fear of a disorder or untidiness. All you neat freaks. I don't suffer that, so I'm okay. Ataliophobia is the fear of failure. Automysiophobia is the fear of being dirty. Odiophobia is the fear of being alone or by oneself. Bacteriophobia is the fear of bacterias. Batavophobia is the fear of stairs. Brontophobia is the fear of lightning. Cancerophobia is what? The fear of
cancer.
Right. Castrophobia is the fear of sitting. Castrophobia is the fear of mirrors. Don't be afraid of mirrors. Please, for the sake of your neighbor, take a look in the morning. Xenophobia is the fear of new things or new ideas. Clidiophobia is the fear of being enclosed, claustrophobic. How many know that? Okay. Coimetrophobia is the fear of cemeteries. Coulterphobia is the fear of clowns. Cineophobia is the fear of dogs. It goes on and on and on and on and on and on and on. All of these are derived from the Prince of Darkness. Do you understand that? He places all these phobias on people so that they don't walk in success and clarity of mind. Are you hearing me? Now, God gives the emotion of fear. Now, to help you understand that, it's a healthy fear. It's a reverence. It's obedience. If not adhered to, will bring consequences. Fear that if not obedient to suffer consequences will come. Fear to have a reverential awe, profound reverence and respect for God. That's a good fear. Awe, an emotion that is inspired by authority. Stand in awe of the King. Reverence, to honor and admire and respect with deep feeling. Don't confuse the spirit of fear with the fear of the Lord. You must have a fear of the Lord. In our country, we have lost the fear of the Lord. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You must have a reverence for the house of God. You must have a reverence for everything that pertains to God. In Psalm 5:7, David said, "In reverence and awe, I will worship you. I will worship toward your holy temple." All true worship is anchored in a reverence for his presence. Leviticus 19:30 tells us, "You shall reverence my sanctuary. I am the Lord. Now, you might feel that this is an old Toyota refurbished building, but we have named it the Sanctuary of God. When you come in here, no longer is this a mechanic's barn, but it is the Sanctuary of God. It is the dwelling place of God. Is somebody hearing me? And you will reverence it. It might not be a Catholic cathedral with stained glass windows, but God abides here. You hear me? You have a reverence. You don't want to do anything that would disturb this sanctuary. You do the right thing. You do what's required. When you come in with respect, you don't have an attitude. I said, I don't want to sit over there. I want to sit over here. I said, I don't want to sit over here. I want to sit over there. Shut up. You have to come in with a reverence. I'm coming into the temple, not into Toyota. You understand the difference? You must reverence God. That's the fear of the Lord. Why? Oh, I don't want to do anything out of order in this place because I want to reverence God. Do you understand the fear of the Lord? Also, we've lost the fear of the Lord. It's a conscious awareness and for doing the right thing. Paying your taxes is doing the right thing. You fear. You have reverence because if you don't pay, what happens? If you don't pay your taxes, what happens? Thank you very much. So you have a reverence, a respect for paying your taxes. Because if you don't pay, there's a consequence. You go to jail, okay? Somebody say hallelujah. Aren't you excited about that? There's no record in the kingdom of God on the mistakes that you made. The only one that has the record is the enemy of your soul, and he wants to bring up your failures and put fear back in your heart and intimidate you. But we will not be intimidated, amen? Give no place for fear to operate in your life. Doubt is the key that opens up the door to fear. Doubt, you begin to doubt. Refuse to allow fear to take any place in your mind. Fear knocks on the door. Faith answers, and there's no one there. Fear runs when it sees faith. Faith is the invisible confidence that something exists other than what you presently see. Say that with me. Faith is the
invisible confidence that something exists other than what you presently see.
Did you catch that? You've got to believe in what God's plan is for you for your life. The internal belief system planted in every human being. You have faith in you. Say, I've got faith in me. Everybody has a portion of faith. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. Fear comes by hearing the lies of the devil. You hear me? Get it straight. Obliterate the lies of defeat. Receive the word of the Lord for your life. And the spirit of Lord, of fear will dissipate in the presence of worship and the word. Fear has got to go. I saw a thing online about this young man who was abducted. I don't know if anybody saw it. And he was abducted. He was 9 years old. Abducted right there in the front of his house. You see that? Put in the van. He started worshiping the Lord. And his abductor said, shut up, shut up. He would not shut up. He kept worshiping the king. I believe, what was the song he sang? I believe in the Lord, or whatever it was. He kept repeating it. He wouldn't shut up. And the guy eventually kicked him out of the van. Do you understand? It stills the Avenger. Now, I don't know how many people would be able to do that. He was an extraordinary. And Hezekiah Walker, he sang Hezekiah Walker's song. And Hezekiah Walker met up with him together. And he was so pleased. I forget the name of the song, Hezekiah Walker. every praise. That's what the little nine-year-old was singing in the van. And so he brought him on stage with him, and he said, look at this, the song that he wrote. Praise, worship, it stills the avenger. You got to do something. Don't sit and wallow in your fear and in your timidity. Pop a CD in there and get praise filling up in your car. And fear has got to bow. It has got to leave you. Amen? Deuteronomy 31:6 says, be strong and of good courage. The Lord your God goes with you.
Be strong and of good courage. Do not fear nor be afraid of them. For the Lord your God, he is the one who goes with you. He will not leave you nor forsake
Somebody
you.
Somebody needs to take that scripture right now. Who is it here? Who is it that needs to take that scripture? Be strong. Have courage. Courage isn't the absence of fear. It's the mastering of it. You understand that? You'll never have an absence of a reason to be afraid, but you can master that through the power of the Word of God. Are you hearing me? Faith robs fear of its power. Faith robs fear of its power. Say it. Faith robs fear of its power. Say it again. Faith robs fear of its power. Faith, faith, faith. Proverbs 28:1 says, the righteous are as bold as a lion. Say, I am the righteous. Say, I am the righteous.
I am the righteous.
I am bold.
I am bold.
As a lion.
As a lion.
Roar. I trust that you only saw a part of it. It was phenomenal here today. But I pray that spirit of freedom came in through your screen, because fear should not be a part of your life. What did you feel was going on in this room today?
You know, Pastor, as you ministered today, I began to watch people actually get free as the Word of God came out of your mouth.
Ah,
freedom of fear.
Yes.
And I really challenge, if somebody's dealing with fear that's watching this, they definitely need to get this series on fear.
Yes, yes,
it's just amazing.
It's powerful. Even when we prayed at the end, if you noticed, people, different ones reacted in different ways. What were you sensing when we were going down that aisle?
You could actually hear the chains fall off of them, that they had been dealing with fear for years and
My
years
God.
And years.
My God.
And you begin to watch people actually transform in their mind and in their face as fear gripped off of them, just fell off of them. It was amazing.
It's a spirit.
It's a spirit.
And yet we flip it and we say that there's another spirit that comes from the Lord, and that's reverence.
It's reverence.
And what's going on in our world today is awful. In our country, there's no reverence for God. There's no fear of God.
I agree.
Men are doing, making laws that they don't even think about the ramifications of leaving God out of it.
Well, there's a level of leadership that I truly believe, as you begin to speak on that second type of fear, there's a level of leadership that we have to understand, that if we have no reverence for God, we have no reverence for the president, we have no reverence for others.
Exactly.
But if we can learn that reverence of the kingdom of God, that's what sets us free from other fears that the enemy tries to bring onto
Amen.
Us.
Amen. Amen. Address the fear to those folks that are watching us right now.
If you're dealing with fear right now, we want to pray for you right now. But there's also a number on the screen that you can call. There are prayer partners standing by right now to actually pray for you. So we want to pray for you. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we speak to the spirit of fear that have bound our friends and neighbors.
My God.
And God, we ask right now, in the name of Jesus, that you set them free, and loose them from this spirit that has captivated them in fear. And Father, we believe them to be set free by the power of God, according to your word, in the name of Jesus, right now.
Jesus. Amen. 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 If you receive that, give us a call and let us know. God has not given you a spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. Give us a call. We'll send you absolutely free the CD and the DVD, whatever you need, and we'll pray with you and agree with you that fear will let go of its grip on you. The Lord bless you. We'll see you next time. Be blessed, highly favored, and empowered to prosper. Bye-bye.